Good afternoon, my name is Alexander and you are on our channel about greenhouses. Today we will talk about what the height of greenhouses should be. Having been building greenhouses for over 10 years, we have built a wide variety of options, communicated with a large number of agronomists and other specialists, and a very interesting question arises: what should be the height of a greenhouse? Some people say that it should be high, others say it should be low. We will now analyze these two opinions and see what are the pros and cons of the first or second option. Let's say a greenhouse should be low. We take a tall greenhouse in the form of a greenhouse. The advantages of this option are as follows. Firstly, this structure is quite easy to heat up, i.e. it has a small volume and therefore heats up easily. This is the first point. The second point is the small area of the cover. This means that such a structure is not difficult to manufacture and, in principle, it can be quickly installed. The disadvantages of this option are as follows. Snow does not come off it well, i.e. it does not come off the dome of the greenhouse. It must be removed and cleaned. This is one. Two, the system heats up very quickly and cools down very quickly, i.e. as soon as the sun comes out, this greenhouse will immediately overheat, and as soon as the sun sets, the greenhouse will immediately cool down. This means that here you either need to create a system of very strict temperature control, because temperature fluctuations greatly affect plants and this hits the yield. That is, if our temperature jumps, and the nuance is that, for example, a low greenhouse cools down very quickly and heats up very quickly, therefore the jumps are very close to those that occur on the street. Okay, if we have a warm period, if we have basically zero temperatures, then this option has its advantages, low cost and ease of heating this greenhouse. These greenhouses can also be installed, but they must be seasonal, that is, they are not designed for growing crops in winter, because it will be very difficult to maintain comfortable temperature conditions in this greenhouse. This is due to the small volume of air and, accordingly, the lack of inertia and temperature fluctuations. This is the first option. The second option is a tall greenhouse. The advantages are as follows. Firstly, we can grow tall plants. This is the first thing. Secondly, it is easier to maintain temperature regimes in this greenhouse, because it is less inert. The temperature is maintained due to the internal volume of air. It is easier to maintain comfortable conditions in this greenhouse, but there are also disadvantages. The first is the cost of the structure, it will be more expensive, and the second is that you need to lay down much more power than, for example, for heating this structure. The question arises, which of these options is better to make a tall or a low greenhouse? In this regard, there are a certain number of myths, because now there are quite a few videos where it is said that the greenhouse should be high. For example, I recently spoke with a customer. He says that the greenhouse should be high there. The width of the greenhouse is 10 meters. We want a very high greenhouse. It will be more economical and all that. But the nuance is that those who talk about high greenhouses are right, but only in another moment. If we have such a high greenhouse, for example, let's take a width of 10 meters and a height of 6, 7, 8 meters. What do we get? We get that we have a huge area of heat loss, and yes, we will have even temperature drops here, and the temperature will be better maintained, but there is a small nuance. It makes sense to make tall greenhouses when we have not one block, but a large number of greenhouses. I have deduced a certain proportion for myself. For example, we have a greenhouse width of 6 meters. We divide it by 16 and get the maximum height for this greenhouse should be no more than 3.6 meters. Why is this so? This is connected, of course, with heat losses. The higher our greenhouse, the more heat losses increase, and, as it were, the cost of the growing process. Therefore, if, for example, the width of our greenhouse is 30 meters, then it makes sense to raise the height to 6 meters. But if we have 6 meters, then there is no point in raising it higher than 3.6 meters. If you have tall plants and you want to grow a lot of them, make a greenhouse 8 meters wide, then you can raise the greenhouse to 4 meters or even 6 meters in general, but in principle, you can raise it to 6 meters. So this is the proportion. If you want to understand what height is optimal for your greenhouse, then the maximum, that is, this is not optimal, this is the maximum height when it makes sense. If you need higher, it is better to take a wider greenhouse, then you can get more, because well, that is, the greenhouse should strive for certain proportions. The maximum height for a 6-meter greenhouse is 3.6 meters. If we need higher 4.5 meters, you can take an 8-meter greenhouse, if we want even higher, then a 10-meter one. There is no point in making, for example, a greenhouse with a width of 6 meters and a height of 6 meters to get an optimal climate. According to the existing dogma that the higher the greenhouse, the better and more comfortable for plants, this is true. For large greenhouses, height matters. For small greenhouses, height should be limited by certain parameters. Parameter 16 is, in principle, close to the golden ratio, so it is better not to go beyond it. In general, according to the norms, for everything to be more proportional, as if arched greenhouses, then arched greenhouses should strive for their radius, that is, the height should be equal to half the width. In general, the height and dimensions of the greenhouse are a very individual parameter, and in general, in principle, it is possible to approach it individually in each case. In some cases, low greenhouses will be ideal, because we do not need to create super cool conditions for growing in winter, we just need to make sure that there is no frost there, that is, to protect plants from low temperatures. If we want to grow in the winter period, and the nuance is that there are very strong temperature fluctuations in the winter and transitional periods, that is, in the greenhouse precisely because at night there can be a very big minus, for example, -20-30, and in the afternoon the sun came out and in the greenhouse, by a natural factor, the temperature heats up to +30, that is, the heating system or the climate control system, that is, it is already difficult to control all these parameters. Summarizing all that has been said, I want to say the following: any greenhouse height makes sense and it is tied to the task that is set for this greenhouse. Small, medium, tall, and in any of these greenhouse options, they work and work optimally in the conditions that we set before them. If we need to protect plants from frost and we do not need heating, a low greenhouse will suit us. If we want to grow in the spring-autumn period, a medium-sized greenhouse will also suit us. If we want to go into winter, then either a medium-sized greenhouse or a tall one, but a tall one in the case when we have certain complexes and a large width of greenhouses. That's basically all I wanted to tell you, that is, I hope this information will help you with the right choice of the proportions of the greenhouse that will be most optimal for you in growing inside the greenhouse. I was with you, Alexander, the company Echo Teplitza. Live in harmony with nature and the rhythm of progress. Good harvests to you.